everybody, it's Emily Dark Schooling, and today I'm going to be bringing you the February Family Reading Crate unboxing. So I'm really excited. This month's box is awesome. The theme for February was birds, and the box, as you can see, is a little bit bigger than last month. That's because there's more in it. This month we had 5 books go out in this box, and I am really excited. So let me just show you what you're gonna get if you ordered the February Bird Box. First up is the booklet. Of course, every box comes with a booklet. This is like a little mini unit study, but not really. This booklet gives you discussion questions for the books. It has a link to take you to our site where we have more links and movies and recommended books and all kinds of things that go along with the theme. So there's lots of great stuff in here. You also get 3 bookmarks. And I'm gonna set the box down so you guys can get a good peek at the bookmarks. So you get 3 bookmarks that go along with the theme. Well, one of them's just a Build Your Library bookmark. This one. And then the 2 that go with a theme, we have their front and back. So each side goes with a different book. And you see there's an African gray parrot on one side. And on the other side, it's a red-tailed hawk. So you get 3 bookmarks. So we have included 2 bird gliders in each one. And these are just, you know, very simple bird gliders. And also there's a note in the booklet on how to get these, all about aerodynamics and how to get these to fly the best. We also included a little stuffed bird because honestly, you guys, my kids are obsessed with stuffed animals. I don't know if yours are. But when we were trying to decide what to put in there, my kids kept saying, you have to include a toy bird. So, much searching, we found this guy. He's really cute, so I hope your kids love him, because my kids are already, like, fighting over who gets whatever's left in the box after I get all the boxes out. So those are all the extras that are going to be in this box. Everything else in here is books. First book that I'm going to show you is the Family Read Aloud. And that is the Desperate Adventures of Zeno and Alia, and this is by Jane Kelly. This book stole my heart. I love it. This is maybe one of my favorite books I've read, and children's books I've read in quite a while. It is just fantastic. The premise of this story sounds a little bit sad, and there are some sad parts in this book, but it's also just beautiful. The main characters that tell the story are Zeno, who is an African gray parrot, and Alia, who is a little girl who is sick with leukemia. Zeno, at the beginning of the book, his owner dies, and he is not understanding what's happened, but he knows his human is no longer going to be able to help him, so he has to go and find his way in the world. And he's a domesticated parrot, but he can still fly, so he just flies off into the city looking for food because he knows no one's going to be bringing him any. And so you get his perspective as he's grappling with this information that he no longer has his human servant to help him. And he's a very smart, I mean, birds are really, really smart. And I love that the author gave Zeno such an interesting voice, and his narration of the story is my favorite thing ever. Just how he is understanding what's happening and how he grapples with it. The other side of the story is Alia, a little girl who is sick with leukemia, and she is starting to give up hope when this strange bird flies to her window looking for his favorite snack, banana muffins. And he is so excited when he finds them and doesn't understand why she isn't willing to help. And so the story is all about their friendship and how he has given her hope. This month you get 2 picture books. The first picture book I want to show you is Arrowhawk, and this is a true survival story by Lola M. Schaefer. And again, this is beautifully, beautifully illustrated. It's a stunning book, and it's told from the perspective of the hawk who gets wounded. He's out flying and doing his own thing, and a hunter shoots him in the leg, and he gets an arrow stuck in his leg. And it's a true story. You can see a picture of the real Arrowhawk on the back of the book. And it, basically, it's about how humans were able to carefully capture him and remove the arrow and rehabilitate him and send him back on his way. I love the fact that this story is about the bird. It isn't about how the great humans came and helped him. It's about the bird and how he was able to survive with this wounded leg for as long as he did. And the humans are sort of in the background. You don't really get to know too much about them, which I think is a cool thing. You don't often see that. The other picture book is United Tweets of America, 50 State Birds, Their Stories, Their Glories by Hudson Talbot. I adore this book. I was so excited to be able to include this in the box. It's so much fun. This is exactly what it is. It's each state and their bird, and it's got kind of a little funny dialogue going with all the birds. It gives you lots of information about each of the states and their state birds and other facts about each state. It's just awesome. It's beautifully illustrated in like a kind of fun cartoony way, but it's also full of great information. So I just think this book is fantastic. The book I've included for older readers, I will say this is definitely for 13 and up, and that is Like Water on Stone by Dana Walrath. This book is beautiful. It's stunning. I loved every second of reading it. It's told in verse, which if you're not used to, does take a little bit of adjustment, but it's so worth it. It's beautiful. This book is about the Armenian Genocide, which is obviously a very serious and upsetting topic, so definitely for 13 and up. This is a story of three siblings and how they were able to survive and get to safety. And it's also told from the perspective of those three siblings, but also of an eagle who is watching over them. And the eagle is telling what he sees of what's happening and how he protects the children. And it's beautiful. It's sad, and there are definitely some, it's very emotional. But it's such an important topic, and one that you don't often see told. I can count on one hand the number of books that I've even seen about this subject matter for children at all. And so I think it is an important topic and one that we should be teaching our children about. And I think this would absolutely lead to a lot of great rabbit trails and research and study, because I know it did for me. As soon as I finished the book, I was like, I need more. I need to know more about what happened and why it happened and how it happened. So yeah, fantastic, fantastic book. And the last book in the box is the one that is for you, the parent, and that is The Atomic Weight of Love by Elizabeth J. Church. This is a story about a woman in the 40s who is coming of age. She's in college, it's like right before the beginning of the war. She goes to school, she's got big dreams of becoming an ornithologist. And just as she's about to start her PhD program, she falls in love with a physics professor, and they get married, and he's much older than her and kind of already set in his ways, and she's just enamored with his genius, basically, and she marries him. They fall in love, and he gets called away to go work on this top secret project on the other side of the country during the war, and obviously he's working on the atomic bomb. But he's not allowed to tell her anything about it, and she ends up going to be with him over there and leaving her studies behind to become his wife and be with him. And this story is a little bit of a romance, but I think more it's about what it was like to be a woman or what it's like to be a woman and have to give up your dreams in order to be a better wife or a mother or any of those things. And I love that Meridian, who is the main character, she never quite gives up those things. She tries. And she tries to make herself fit into this box of perfect, proper housewife, but she never quite makes that adjustment work for her. And she makes some bad decisions along the way, and I think it's a very true look at what that would have been like. And it goes from her life through the 40s all the way up until she's an elderly woman, in the 1990s, early 2000s, I can't remember. And she studies crows. That's, each chapter has a chapter name and heading that has to do with birds and ornithology, and it's, I love how she studies the crows and befriends them and, like, recognizes them and gives them names. But I honestly, this is one of the best books I've read that would be defined as a romance, because I really don't like romance, but I thought this book was just fantastic. I really enjoyed it quite a lot. I love the title. That's kind of what drew me to the book in the first place. That's what you'll get in the February Family Reading Crate. If you want to know more, I'm going to leave a link below for you guys to check out more information. We're about to open we'll be opening the pre-orders at the beginning of February for the March crate. And the theme for March is goblins, magic, and fantasy. Oh my! I'm so excited about that crate, you guys. I've got some really great books coming up for that. If you guys enjoyed this video, I'm really excited about my family reading crates. They're awesome. I hope you guys enjoy them as much as I enjoy putting them together. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Happy reading. Bye!